kings. We will try to dash to diamond. And I just rolled the quest to deal 100 frost damage. Mainly because I have a 1000 win on the mage. So if I would get wins with mage, I would not simply not get achievements for the twins. Disgusting, we don't have any good turn. Okay, we have turn 4. This is terrible turn 4, but it will be functional turn 4. Look at this, so fucking... No. Theoretically, 1 HP enemy is... Okay, let's start making profile. Secret guy.
Come in, come in. Everyone's a winner.
Weird, but okay. And we need something that could deal with elemental. I have 2 damage, so I didn't play the weapon. I like this rush minion. Rush honorable kill. Rush beast and rush demon. Rush demon is worst. Idea is to play 4 mana pirate. And potentially finish with Rush Demon if I get empty board. In my opinion, mistake. Unless you wanna do that. Okay, that way. We do this. And we do this. In face. Okay, this two will progress the quest next turn. By the way, why does he play secret mage? This is secret hero power mage, so it's not a regular secret mage. Okay, here we naturally do this. We do this, which is kind of bad. We do this, and we armor. Armor is extremely valuable in this match. I mean, instead of armor, I could replace this guy with this, but I was frozen, so... There is nothing to gain from that play. If you control secret, whatever. Honestly, this is very good play on my side because I will be able to play also this. You think it's counterspell? Annoying, but nothing crucial. We'll play this minion. Actually, let's check quest progress. Probably this minion. Holy shit, that's so annoying. Okay. This is 4 damage. This is 3 damage, so we play like this. This is 4 damage, so we play like this. And like this. I consider this usage of weapon as good. We can hero power him to death right now. I will probably hero power this guy. No. There will be trade unless he hero power. Should I hero power my own guy? Kind of stupid. I kind of don't like it. Yeah, hero powering my own guy feels kind of idiotic. And yet I have to do it. This is most valuable play right now. He will play Hero Portrait. If so, there are some preps done. This looks like pre-hero or... I can take him. Weird. I mean, I will have cannons. If cannon shot here, I will Hero Power. Okay. Let's eliminate hero power. Okay, let's enable hero power. I wanna have taunt. And maybe this. This is kind of useless because he can play this stupid hero minion. 10 mana deal 10. 8 mana deal 10. Extremely overpowered. Would he have 3 cards? Never mind. He have this one. We hero power this beat, Mr. Smite. Mostly because that's the best play in that turn. Mhm. Honestly, we play like this, and we consider little, 9, a little. And I also add armor. Yeah, very good game. Okay, I know it's I blame my slime enemies. Let's continue. Honestly, finding a game is pretty okay. Hunter. Hunter can be either Face Hunter, Detrattle Hunter, or Quest Hunter. Most commonly you meet face hunters, but you should not tunnel vision into one archetype. We need to play on curve. There is absolutely nothing you can do with that. Progressing the quest is most important thing you can do. Okay, this is great. I have no idea who told you that I will be doing anything else than playing these minions. Honestly, we can delay this guy. Play this on turn 3. What a fucking stupid play. Please stop. Holy shit. Oh, this is so dumb. Oh. Oh. Okay. Okay, this is G. I mean, there's nothing you can do. Grats. That was so good counterplay. That was phenomenal counterplay. Why? Tap deck. Whenever you have a choice to play from hand and from tap deck, always tap deck. Because it's more scammy. He have 4 mana. He will most likely trade if he have mind. He didn't trade. Okay. No problem. We'll hero power. This is Face Hunter. Hero powering against this guy is absolutely fantastic. Honestly, I have no idea why he didn't. I mean, great, of course, but whatever. We want a hero power for sure. Next turn, Akara. I was considering attacking with weaker weapon to have 4 attack on this guy, but it's not that relevant. Yeah, we definitely Rokara. Okay. Yeah, Rokara will push out and we will be able to have little. Unstoppable. Perfect. Yeah, we need to skip this. We're going to diamond. We have no time to celebrate. I will pause on diamond and return like a few days later. I mostly wanna goof around with my worst decks. Okay, this is Paladin. I don't like trading entire hand, but okay, honestly, it was very good trade. We might consider not coining because we will need coin for potential bad tap deck. Okay, honestly, we do it like this. This was best play. Another play was objectively worse because you cannot make better play than best play. I don't know why they played these trots. I mean, they should probably realize by now that this only works for low IQ enemies. Okay, we play this guy. If this would have more HP. Do I wanna face it? Kind of annoying. We spam minions and we face. He just draw it from this gear, so it was zero. Lucky draw for him. This kind of lower potential of my hand and basically lower my future plays would strongly increase power of my board. We will full face probably. He will most likely play this holy spell. We will kill 1 HP. Why? We will kill 1 HP enemy. One from three. Very slow. By the way, I think you can see that we are basically starving on cards. 4 HP. This. You play this to discover other minion. That way you can use your stupid weapon. Okay, he will most likely have to play direct damage, and he has not enough mana to play this woman, this 7 mana thing. Okay, we trade. Holy shit, okay, this is disgusting because I need to play this guy. And I need to hope one of my cannonballs hit. Please, nice. You need to face. Because he can play Kariel now, and that will be only occasion to deal him real damage. If he play Kariel, he will get 5 HP, he will get double damage reduction. It will be nightmare, and he will also kill this for 3. Okay, it's not nightmare, but it's still terrible. And that's straight. And he will instantly play it on other minion. We have to stall somehow. Next turn we play Rokara and we have enough damage to kill him. Problem is, I might not be brave enough to kill him. I mean, to heal kill. Can. Okay, never mind. I should have not attack this guy. That was. I mean, it's most likely GG from the start since this is Paladin. And in Paladin Stone, you cannot win against Paladin. That's the rule. I didn't make the rules. And sure, you might say, fuck the rules, why do we even listen to it in the first place, but sadly, there is nothing you can do. Bizarre Entertainment decided to make game sufficient for idiots who play fucking idiotic paladin, and that's what we do. There is absolutely no worst piece of trash than fucking Paladin in this entire fucking game. Paladin always suck, always is too strong, and always fucking have best hero power in the game. That is absolutely snowballed as fuck. And yet, they give him so fucking strong cards that playing hero power on Paladin is useless. Nobody play hero power on this shit. Even on Pirate Warrior I play fucking armor. It's not always the best play, but it's sometimes best play. Sometimes. You're not Paladin, you basically never play hero power unless you are in absolute shit. We need low mana cost cards. And we play curve. Nothing can do. Okay, we have variation. We play this draw weapon attack. Okay, this is great. This is forced hero power, a very popular play. You basically play two health minion when enemy can kill him. In the past you played one health minion for this. Why? I don't know. Holy fuck shit, I hate this play. Okay. This play has like nothing, honestly. Like, he have advantage on the board right now. I wanna play this guy because I will be able to play this gear. And I will be able to get my weapon for zero. And we save HP by trading. HP of my minions is irrelevant in this situation. He can basically play 4 mana gear and basically do this. We face. Not ultra face, but a notch face. Like, this is not face. This is face. You need to keep balance. We can play both of these cards next turn. And he must kill this. There's absolutely no way he can allow it to live. Because of this, he will not be able to play any of his 4 mana cards unless he have 1 mana removal. And I doubt it. Exactly 3 mana each sheet. Insufficient play each sheet. Okay, whatever, I don't care. Honestly, this might change my play, because now it's inefficient. Please face the thing. Anyway, now it's inefficient to play this. Because there is no better play than playing Krokara. And he must kill this for one. There is no fucking way in hell he allow it to live. That's so fucking sweet. That was so fucking cute. And that was so fucking useless. Oh. Okay. Okay. Easy. Easy. Holy shit. GG. I consider attacking face. Bonk. My biggest problem in this game is that your enemy is fucking retarded and he always takes his time to think. So naturally I already won, but look at this clown. Useless, too late. I made a mistake. I made a mistake. That's still a mistake. Holy fucking shit, my bad. Where my head? I don't know what happened to me. I mean, lucky for me, my mistake was. Wait, I will have armor. Armor. Anyway, that was pathetic on my side. I'm sorry. I also sorry for my enemy that he had to watch this. That was sad. I forgot this pirate only shoot when you have weapon. Because I usually have this four condition weapon, that one attack weapon, and they usually shot or not.
Light makes right.
Now you're saving on mine.
Okay. I can keep this for mana because I have coin. Okay. There are two possibilities to play. We can HR play with coin instantly. But there is better play to wait and build up it for two. And this will allow me to get armor over time. It's not relevant against this enemy. Because this is Big Priest. And the goal of the Big Priest is to start the game to endless of time. We soon start facing very big size minions. Now question is if he had God Hand or not. He does not, okay, we rush. This priest has no business in winning this game. There is absolutely no possibilities. I can tell you something about big priests. They are useless, I played them. There is absolutely no fucking way this guy win anything. This is good because it's fast and cheap. And we can load it attack. Okay, this is first turn when your enemy can have play. Okay, never mind. Hysteria is too expensive for him right now. He can only use Holy Smite. And he must Holy Smite if he wanna survive. We play 4 mana guy and we most likely waste axe. Holy Smite 33, dude. What are you doing? Another play is worse. Okay, he gave up.
Gotta get through me.
I never seen a play like this. That was kind of impressive for a walking sack of meat.
Look at that.
Okay, we did this. My god, I should have traded with 4-1. I don't know why I didn't trade with 4-1, that was so fucking stupid. By the way, if you think I'm playing Merciless, this is basically how you play against this deck. You have no chance if you will not play fast.
Your cutlass, flip,
I always shoot cannons here, so... The clearing the board is irrelevant for you in this matchup because your enemy will clear the board every fucking turn. How far we are? Okay, we can play 2-5 in next turn. Or we can play 3 little. No. No. I honestly never seen a priest playing like that. I play worse in my priest than he play. If I play 6 mana, I will have 6 more damage to outdo what he healed. It's more efficient to play this. And we need to trade. This is the best trade we can perform. Both trades involve similar resources, but this makes it harder for him to buff minion to giant size. We get a weapon next turn, and we will most likely shoot this divine shield. Okay, this is extremely problematic because... Honestly? Okay, never mind. All my problems are gone now because everything he can ever do against this shit is irrelevant. How much damage it is? Nine. Five, okay, 5 of little. We trade. Face. Trade, face. That was best I could do in this turn. He must play Zyrella if he just get it. We will feed on this world. Too slow. I didn't expect it. Okay. We have 5 damage, 6, 1 damage, fuck. Okay, 2 damage. Okay, 11 damage. This is 11 damage. And now question, where is the rest? I hit this for 11 damage. I hit this and hero power. Okay, great. I mean, I feel kind of sorry that this priest played very well. I could not play better with priest. But sadly, I had advantage from the start. If I won, that will be last game for now. I would call this session very successful because we got it to diamond. But honestly, I don't know, I should probably not say like it's over. This is good hand. I can get better hand, but I don't have coins, so I don't wanna risk. And this is also forced to trade in case if it's hero power mage. I forgot this card exists in Magic. I have only one. Most warrior play 2, I play 1 because I don't like it. I mean, I like it enough to play 1, but not enough to play 2. This is forced to trade. There is absolutely no way he will not trade. This and then turn. Next turn we play 3 mana and weapon. And this is not exactly forcing to do anything. Okay, now we will be able to protect this guy. Okay, this is forced to hero power. I don't like it. I don't like sacrificing this guy. But it's much, much faster play than alternatives. Hero power and 2 mana to 3. Useless. He can face. Everything is irrelevant here. He can play second one of this, but it's not enough. Irrelevant. Okay. I will show you something. You attack first to have 5 damage here. Fuck, my bad. I didn't count it. Okay, let's pretend these 2 balls hit his base. My fucking god, that was terrible. He must play something useful. Okay, that's relevant. Minimal risk. I must play this. I will grab trade a card. Okay, I feel kind of useless in this play. I only play it to absorb play damage. No force on Azeroth can stop me. Bonk. Doesn't matter. He will play Hero Pulse right now. It will increase damage of his hero power. And it will play this Shadow Bolt 10. Useless. Useless and irrelevant. I will Rokara his face.
Nobody saw anything.
Yeah. And that way we are in diamond. I will just show you how I get in diamond. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and sorry for that one fatal misplay.